Have you ever asked yourself how to best develop adaptive AUTOSAR software?
Sure.
There is the possibility to hand-code C++ applications. Another way to develop high-quality software for the new ECU generations with adaptive AUTOSAR is using a model-based approach. Today, I would like to cover exactly this topic, and I'd like to spend a few words on why model-based development, that is MBD, and TargetLink are also ideally suited for adaptive AUTOSAR and, of course, in the end, show the process in reality. Hi, my name is Sascha Ridder, and in today's Innovation Coffee Break, we'll be looking at the development process for using TargetLink to generate adaptive AUTOSAR. I started with a promise to explain why the MBD approach is also worthwhile for adaptive AUTOSAR. A basic advantage of MBD is, of course, that only one artifact runs through the entire development process, be it classic, adaptive, or even non-AUTOSAR, namely the model. This is because the model is requirement, functional description, and in the end, the starting point for the production code. Using only one specific artifact through the development process enables potential errors. Another plus of MBD tool chains is, of course, that 20 years of developing software with MBD products created an entire ecosystem from architecture specifications over code generation and testing and securing car functions, all proven in practice for many years, also in classic AUTOSAR environments. Furthermore, with the introduction of the new adaptive AUTOSAR standard, the committee has chosen a modern programming language, C++ 14. The flexibility and amount of functionality offered by C++ 14 is almost infinite, and thus also possesses certain hurdles: high complexity and difficult validation, which, however, is a top priority for the automotive industry. And here, the advantage of autocode generators is that they abstract the function of the application from the actual implementation, taking care about the optimal way of writing code and thus reduce the actual complexity of the programming language. Of course, these are only a few reasons that speak for an adaptive AUTOSAR MBD toolchain. After this abstract preface, I would like now to move on to the more practical part of the event and show that a service-oriented architecture can be mapped using dSPACE MBD tools. In the demo, I will show you the development process of an adaptive AUTOSAR application with TargetLink. I start with all necessary adaptive AUTOSAR informations imported via the familiar ARXML format into TargetLink's central data store, the TargetLink data dictionary. And after that, I'm ready to create a frame model with all ports and service interfaces specified, so that I can either integrate the already developed functionalities directly into the model or start my development task with a prepared frame model. And today, after generating the frame model, I will use an already finished model and show some communication types and adaptive AUTOSAR modeling styles in TargetLink. Of course, after code generation, I will also explain how SIL simulation can be done in TargetLink without the need for an adaptive AUTOSAR middleware. The scenario consists of a sensor, a controller, and an actuator. The rain sensor, which provides the input signal for the TargetLink components, measures if and how much rain hits the window. The wiper controller, modeled in TargetLink, controls how fast the wiper should move, where the actuator, the wiper actuator, processes these information and sends information to the wiper motor. Further steps such as the integration with other parts of the software, the preparation for the simulation on either the Adaptive AUTOSAR demonstrator or the dSPACE testing solution, I'm going to skip, as those steps were already shown by Fabian Bronner in his innovation coffee break. You can find the link to this event in the show notes. But now, let's take a closer look onto the model. Now, as mentioned, I will start with an already prepared data dictionary. Prepared means that I've already imported the Adaptive AUTOSAR specifications into TargetLink's data dictionary. Here, architecture specifications are centrally stored in the AUTOSAR node. And those are service interfaces, software components, and their ports. The currently supported use cases are sending or receiving events, accessing fields, or calling or implementing methods for the ARACOM cluster. TargetLink also supports access to key value pairs via the Adaptive AUTOSAR persistency cluster. Also specifiable in the TargetLink data dictionary are service discoveries. A service discovery ensures that the appropriate service is requested either to send information to it or to receive information from it. For this purpose, TargetLink offers different identification mechanisms to find a service provider or receiver. And additionally, there is a TargetLink specific construct, the so-called Adaptive AUTOSAR functions, which are in analogy to the classic AUTOSAR runnables. Now, since all necessary information is specified, I can now generate a frame model of the Adaptive AUTOSAR software component. And in order to do this, I just select the software component, click on it with the right, search for the AUTOSAR tools, and with the still very young functionality, create Adaptive AUTOSAR function frame, and now can generate fully automatically a completely specified Adaptive AUTOSAR frame model. And this frame model contains exactly those model elements that are specified by the Adaptive AUTOSAR architecture. And as you remember, there was a persistency element specified in the data dictionary. In TargetLink, we model the access to the persistency cluster via a data store memory block. And the RAIN intensity threshold is one of them. Also, you can see two subsystems. The wiper actuator sends a signal to the wiper to be moved, and the rain sensing control subsystem processes the information on how much rain falls onto the window. The rain sensing control subsystem, the appropriate read access to the memory location, is modeled via a data store read block. The writing is, of course, done by the appropriate data store write block, respectively. And this subsystem is specified as an Adaptive AUTOSAR function, and hence is generated accordingly in the appropriate module, which I named controller function. The Adaptive AUTOSAR ports, and thus their interfaces, are referenced at the TargetLink inputs and outputs. Of course, the frame model must still be filled with content. This can either be modeled in the frame model or just by using a Simulink reference mechanism. Today, I will start with an already prepared model. And as you can see here, there is no direct connection between the two subsystems. Here, the communication between both is modeled via a shared variable, and its access is done via a data store. In this case, the wiper state. In the rain sensing control subsystem, I've built in a decision logic that activates or deactivates the wiper depending on the rain intensity. Another exciting subsystem is this one, the if action subsystem executing the else condition. This is where our first implementation of the access to the ARA long cluster is modeled. This cluster takes care of reporting and adaptive AUTOSAR communication. But now, to the probably most important part, the code generation. And I'm going to do that via the main menu. In addition to the most familiar things in the code generation mode, like Atos, Standard, Classic AUTOSAR, now Adaptive AUTOSAR has been added to this list. Clicking on Build SIL creates a code in the background and compiles it for the simulation in the development environment with TargetLink. Now that the code has been generated, I would like to look at it and briefly describe some special characteristics. Among the many code files, two are particularly interesting: the controller function.cpp and the wiper controller software component adapter.cpp. The controller function.cpp contains, as the name suggests, the adaptive AUTOSAR behavior code, in other words, the functionality that was modeled within the adaptive AUTOSAR functions. It also contains the calls to our adaptive AUTOSAR adapter code. We introduced this to act as an intermediate layer between functionality and adaptive AUTOSAR middleware for full flexibility. The wiper controller software component adapter.cpp contains the adaptive AUTOSAR adapter code. The code here is designed in such a way that during a SIL, the adaptive AUTOSAR parts are deactivated via an if and def statement or are activated for the production code in the end. And this means that the code can be simulated directly in TargetLink in the usual way. Importantly, for adaptive AUTOSAR, you would actually need to build the complete adaptive AUTOSAR application to test it, for example, on the adaptive AUTOSAR demonstrator, which is POSIX based and mostly run on a Linux system. And this is potentially running on a VM and so on and so on. And that means it is a very time-consuming and complex process. And uniquely to TargetLink, though, this saves you this work by providing first functional test capabilities via SIL directly in the development environment and without the complete process or even some kind of middleware for adaptive AUTOSAR. And this is exactly what I want to do now. So the model is in SIL mode, and this is where I'm going to run the simulation. And as you can see, a wiping process is triggered always for a certain input signal from the rain sensor if the threshold is surpassed. After showing you a possible implementation of an adaptive AUTOSAR component in TargetLink, I would like to briefly summarize this innovation coffee break. I hope that after this excursion into the MBD world, everyone agrees that MBD is ready for use in the new ECU architectures and adaptive AUTOSAR. Because MBD, in addition to a broad ecosystem, offers the possibility to move between the different worlds of non-classic as well as adaptive AUTOSAR, C or C++ at the push of a button. In this sense, thanks for listening, and I hope you learned something new about MBD and TargetLink. If I could arouse your interest in adaptive AUTOSAR software development with TargetLink, just write me to get into a deeper conversation about it.